Hi guys, this is Anne. In this video, I'm going to share with you how to use StarCDFX Smart Trading Tool. A lot of people always ask me question, what kind of tool that I'm using? This is the tool that my husband created over 5 years ago, and I have been using it since then, and it really helped me to analyze the market. So this trading tool is a utility. It is like an EA, but it doesn't trade for you. This is especially for manual trader to analyze your chart, plus also for managing your risk per trade. So let's begin. Let's take a look how it looks like and how you can use it. So first, I'm going to show it to you, the properties, what it has, the futures and everything, and I'm going to explain one by one. So it has the money management here, which is to me the most important thing of all the futures it has. And then there is trailing stop, and it has also screen information. There is price levels you can choose from, and affirmation if you want to use. There is financial news, drawing tool, and color modification. And another one which is new, you have auto order on order block. Bear in mind, this tool does not create order block or choose order block for you. I will just explain it to you how this works, all right? And also notification for you to be able to receive an alert whenever the price hit your order block. So now let's start it from here on money management. I will explain about partial close later. Right now, let's just focus from here. Choose lot size money management. I would recommend to use dollar amount. You have two options. You can choose dollar amount and fixed lot. Let me explain for dollar amount, okay? First, you have to put your equity. I would suggest if your capital is above 1,000, you do not need to change anything over here because the tool will calculate automatically the lot size based on the compounding from this 1,000. Let's say here I created an FTMO demo account of 50,000, and then I risk $2 for every 1,000. To make it easy to calculate, I put it here 10, meaning I risk 1% if I put it here 10, because $10 is 1% out of 1,000. So if my account is 50,000, it will automatically risk 500. Now, unless your account is less than 1,000, you need to change this one. For example, if your account is 200, you just put it 200. And then here you probably want to risk $1 for every 200. You can do that. But if your account is above 1,000 or starting from 1,000, you just can use default. But here, the amount you are willing to lose per trade is 0.2%. This is not even 0.5% because we want to make sure for those who doesn't know how to use this tool, they do not make any mistakes. So we put it as low as possible per trade. So if you want to change it, for example, become 0.5%, you just put it 5. If you want to risk 1%, you just put it 10, and then it will calculate automatically. Now for the sake of example, let's put it 0.5%. So this is $5 from 1,000 is 0.5%. So if my account is 50,000, it will automatically risk about $250. Here, there is broker's commission per lot. We want to make sure this $5 is already included commission to the broker. This $3 is only one trip. Usually a broker charges $7 round trip, meaning for buy and sell back and forth, but you will only buy or you will only sell, so you just put it here half of it. So in this case you can put 3.5 or 3. You just find out what is your broker commission per one lot and then divide it into 2, so you put it here. But usually the broker charge you around $6 to $7 per one lot, so we put it here 3. Now as the stop loss, there are 3 options here. You can choose fix, last candle high low, or last high low. By default, it is last high low. You can change it at any time, and I'm gonna show it to you later how it works, okay? And here, risk reward, this is for take profit. Value 5 means 1 to 5. I always suggest everyone who trade the order block to aim at least 1 to 5. Let me show it to you. For example, this is your trade. This is your stop loss. This is your entry. So the tool will calculate automatically that your take profit will be 5 times bigger than your stop loss. And if you want to put fixed stop loss. This is in points, so this is the same just like for pips, and additional stop loss in points if you want to add. If not, you just can ignore this. Maximum spread, these 2 pips, but we put it in points. And this is, you just can leave it as it is. Again, the most important thing is here. If your equity is more than 1,000, you do not need to change anything. You just need to change here. If you want to change the 0.5% per trade, so you just put it 5. If you want to risk 1%, you put it 10. Now, for the sake of example, I will put it 0.5%. So it means I will risk 250. Now let's take a look. Here, by default, my take profit was 1 to 5. Let's say this is my order block. I want to sell, for example, when the price reach this one. So what I do, I click pending sell here. Now you see 2 lines. The red line is your stop loss. You adjust it first, and then here your entry is the blue line over here. This is not going to be active until you click send order. Now let's see, click send order over here. This automatically will take 1 to 5. Let's take a look, because by default we are aiming 1 to 5. Hold on a second, it should be like around 1 to 5 over here. This is automatically give you 1 to 5. Now, since I risk $5 for every 1,000 and my account is 50,000, take a look over here. Can you see that? 247. This is the amount I'm willing to lose, which is the same, just like 0.5% of this. Now, this is on H4, all right? Now, if you can take a look, it takes about 25 pips. The EA will calculate the lot size based on our risk appetite. So you do not have to calculate this anymore. This is on H4. If you want to trade it on M15, it doesn't matter. Now, let's say you want to buy from here. This is pending buy over here, and this is your stop loss. And click sending order. Take a look over here. Looks 239. It is close to 250, because that is how the lot size calculated. So you will always risk the same per trade, regardless time frame, regardless the pairs. Let's say you want to sell on gold, and this is the order block, right? I'm not explaining the strategy here, but this is how I usually enter the market. Let's say I want to enter at 50%, so I click pending sell, that I only want to start selling gold if the price reaching this area, after I adjust where the stop loss is, where the entry price is, and then I click send order, and it's become active like this. Take a look, it takes 0.20 lot. Because the higher the time frame, the lower the lot size is. But if we take a look at the stop loss over here, look, it always gives you around 250, which is 0.5% of every trade. So it doesn't matter you trade on D1, H4, H1, on indices, on Forex, on futures, on cryptocurrencies. Every single risk will always risk the same. This is very important for your money management. And I already created the money management video. I will leave the link below in the description so you can watch it. So I just want to show you how this tool works. If we want to directly buy, for example, it's the same. For the sake of example, I will just buy directly. Now click buy now. Here, stop loss is last low. This is known as the last low. Now take a look, because there is additional stop loss in points 10. So look at that, it gives you about 1 pips. Now if I put it 0, take a look, if I put buy now, it is exactly at the last low. So now you understand, this is additional stop loss in points. If you want to add it or not, by default it gives you additional 1 pip. If you do not want to add additional stop loss, you just put it at 0 like that. Now this is the last low, and again the take profit is the same. Let's click buy now. You didn't see the blue line because it is a direct order, buy now, sell now. But if you click pending buy, you have to adjust first where do you want to put your pending order. Because if you put it at the top and then you click send order, this will automatically become buy stop. If you want pending buy again and the price over here below it, and take a look, it will become by limit. So you do not have to think, is it by limit, is it by stop? The tool already understand and will adjust it for you, both the lot size and the type of order. Now take a look again here, the stop loss almost around 250. It will not more than 250. Sometimes it could be more than 250, but it will not be like 280, no, because we specify we do not want to risk more than 0.5% of our equity by adjusting it from here. So here $5, but it will calculate it automatically whatever your equity is. Let's see if you want to buy now. Click buy now. Let's say you want to put your stop loss here. All you have to do, you just click send order over here, and now it's active. This is not a strategy at all. I just buy it just like that to show it to you that if you click buy now or sell now, it will not directly active until you click send order. Now, here's the thing. If I want to close partial, but right now this is still negative, so it will not be able to close partial. But once it is profiting, for example, you already profit $100 and then you want to close half of it, you want to close $50, you just click close partial here. Because by default here, you set it up 50%. It will close half whatever it is, the lot size that is given by the tool. So in this instance, it will close 0.75 lot size. Let's make this go, and hopefully that this sample will give some profit a little bit, and then so we can see if I can close partial here, but it has to be positive first. Let me explain something else about the trailing stop. If you set it to true, here's how it works. Trail stop number one at 5, let's say you are aiming 129 for the sake of example. You make trail stop to true, trail stop number one at 5, meaning if the price has reached 125, then move stop loss to 0, meaning to the entry. By default it is 5, so for example trail stop number 2 is 10, meaning for example you aim 1 to 20. If the price has reached 1 to 10, move stop loss to 1 to 5, something like that. Look, so in case you want to know how I used it, I usually used it if I aim 1 to 10. I usually make this true and then trail number 1 at 5, move stop loss to 1. So my trade usually, if the price reach 1 to 5, then the stop loss will be moved to 1. That is my break even point. So either I lose or hit break even at 1 to 1, or I win 1 to 10. That's it. I just do not want to complicated things. Unless if I am 1 to 5, then either I lose or I win 1 to 5. That's what I usually do. But it's up to you. Maybe you want to change it. If the price moved to 1 to 2, I want to move it into break even. So what you have to do, you just put it here in trailing stop. Make sure you make it true. And then trail stop number 1, meaning when do you want to start the stop loss to be moved? When the price reach at 1 to 2. Move stop loss to where? 0, meaning to entry. If you moved it to 1, meaning you moved it 1 to 1. So the stop loss is 1 to 1 based on this calculation. I hope that you understand. You really have to play around this. Now, let's go to screen information. There are a lot of information here. By default, we just show you the instrument ADR, meaning average daily range. And here, there are a lot of information. You do not have to show it like everything. If you want to show, for example, current trades, make it true, you will see around here. You do not have to click on terminal and then take a look what is what. You can take a look around here. That is from show current trade. And if you do not want to show the whole screen information, if it is disturbing for you, you just can make it false like that, so it will be gone. Now there is hide panel here, which is very easy, so you just can hide and it is cleaner. If you want to hide this affirmation, you just click F7. All you have to do, you just make it false. Now here's the thing, I want to tell you, you can change the font name and also the font size. Over here, if you change this, by default it is 9, it will affect the drawing tool as well, not only for the affirmation. Let's just put it 12. Take a look at this text and also this drawing tool. Look, it's become very big, right? Oh, where is, oh, I make it false. Sorry. There you go, it's become very big. If your monitor is too small or too big, you can always adjust it here. By default, it is 9. If you wanna change the space from the left and also from the top, you can adjust it around here. Now, another thing here, if you want to adjust the drawing tool, because sometimes if it is too big, you cannot see here, you can also adjust it from here. Space from the left, space from the top. Example, if you want to put it space from the top, let's say 20. Now take a look here on the drawing tool. It's getting lower. I make it become 9 back. So you can adjust everything because of the monitor size. It can affect the look. You can adjust for your own comfortability because sometimes it depends on the monitor. You just need to play around with all this. Here, also the same for screen information. You also can adjust space from the top, space from the left. Maybe you want to put the panel around here or around here. You just can adjust this by looking at the screen information over here. Space from the top is 50. Let's say now if I put it 100, what happened? Look, this is 100 from the top. So you basically you can adjust wherever you want to put the trading panel. This is by default, it is 15. Here is a good example. For the close partial, now this is already profiting. Now let's take a look. If I want to close this close partial, because by default it is 50%. Now you will see a pop-up. Do you wish to partial close all profit order by 50%? If say yes, now it is 60, it will become 30. Take a look. There you go, more or less. Ah, because of the commission and everything. It was 1.5 lot size now become 0.75%. So you just have to click this one. Now let's take a look if we want to close this 0.5% again, 50% again. Let's see what happened. Take a look. This is 0.75. And here you will see a pop up. It will not directly close. It want to make sure that you want to close it and click OK. There you go. It's become 0.37 and the rest is still running over here. So that is how partial close looks like. Now, let me show it to you. Here, you probably want to take a look at the news. To make sure you have the news, you have to click tools, option, and here, expert advisor, make sure allow automated trading. And by default on MT4, it usually disables like that. You have to uncheck these two and then click allow web request for listed URL. You need to enter this link over here, nfs.faireconomy.media. This is for the news. If you do not want to see the news, you just click news off. Now, let's see another thing what I haven't explained it to you yet. Screen information is done. Now here, price level. I personally do not really use it, but let's just use classical. So you want to display, for example, pivot point here, true. You want to show, for example, resistance 1 and resistance 2. Let's see what happened. There you go. You see, this is a pivot point. This is resistance. This is support. And another one, let's see, what do you want to make it available? Let's say you want round number gaps in pips 50. By default, you can change it at any time. When you click, you can change the color. So in between, the round number is about 50 pips. It may not be really clear. You can change the color in color modification. Hold on a second. Here, round number. So if you use round number to trade, you can use that as well. And now if you wanna see monthly high low or weekly open, whatever here you want for the price level, we already have it. So this is the weekly open, this is monthly low, and this is monthly high. Let me show it to you. Why some people need that, I will just give you a quick example. Weekly open, for example. If the price goes below weekly open, it usually sell. If the price goes above weekly open, it usually going buy. Basically, you just can trade every Monday. If the price is above weekly. You just keep buying and you can close it on Friday. That's what you can do. This is just a little tips on how you can use the price level, like a strategy kind of the price level. If you are using weekly open, you can make it. And then every Monday, you take a look. The price is running below weekly open. So there is high possibility that the price is going to go lower, that you can do that with weekly open. And probably there are some other people who use the strategy using the price level around here. So I already explained money management and then trailing stop. Screen information done, price level done, affirmation done. Here, financial news. You can make it false or you can make it true. Just make it false, because if you want to make it true, you just can simply click here, news on, news off. And here's also one thing. If you want a pending sell or pending buy and you decide you want to cancel, you just click cancel order, because every single order will only become active if you click send order. Now let's go to another one. Here there is alert on order block. How does it work? Let's just go to M5. This is for the heck of example. There is an order block around here and you just draw it. Make sure it is non-selected like that. When the price reach there, there will be a pop-up telling you that the order block has been hit. Hold on a second, let me just wait for this. You see, Euro US dollar M5, your order block is hit by the price. So you draw your order block in whatever time frame. When it hit by the price like this, you got the alert to your cell phone. Push notification is already true by default. If you want email notification, you also can make it true, but you need another adjustment. But usually people just use push notification, so you can receive that via the phone that your order block has been hit, something like that. To do that, you have to click on tool option and here notification, enable push notification, and here you can put your MetaQuotes ID on your phone. This is what you need to do. This is selected. There are four dots. It means it is selected. If the box is selected, the price will not send you an alert. You need to make it unselected, non-active, something like that. That's how it works. So imagine around here, right? This is the order block. You can draw with any box over here, either blue, green, or this one gray, or this box red, blue, whatever box around here, or whatever color, even if you changed it, as long as it is rectangle, when the price hit your order blocks, it will send you an alert. Let's say this is on a VPS, just like me sending you an alert. You can highlight this even until here, but the price understand that there is an order block over here. So when the price reach this area, which is the same just like your order block, it will send you notification. So you do not always have to adjust, for example, as long as the price like this. No, even if it is short like this, the moment the price hit, it will send you the alert. But you need to have a VPS, because if you run it on your desktop, you need to have your desktop run like 24 hours. So you need a VPS, and I would suggest using the CNS, the hosting. I give you the link in the forums. They have 100% uptime for their VPS. So now you already know, you can draw, you can mark your order block anywhere and then wait for the price to hit. Either you choose it on M15, M5, it will send you notification. Another one, this is very important, and this is only for advanced trader. I make it false by default because, to be honest, if you are not familiar, it could be dangerous. But now I will explain to you, and you really need to pay attention how this works. Now I will make it true. Re-entry 3 times, or you can make it 1 or 0, it's up to you. But I make it 3 as default because this is my default. And here, how it works, auto order on order block. So now, for example, I have an order block here. I draw this. And again, you have to make it non-active. When the price reach here, it will open order. It will put a stop loss over here and entry over here and put 1 to 5, because by default it was 1 to 5. You can always adjust it. That's how it works. And what this re-entry means over here, in case the price is passing the order block, that means it hit a stop loss, right? When it hit a stop loss, the tool will directly place another order, which become a sell stop over here at the same level, stop loss and entry. Imagine the price from here going up, so it hit a stop loss, and then the price will place another entry over here. So when it's come back, it's become sell stop, it's become active again. Because we all know sometimes the order block does not work right away. Sometimes it hit a stop loss 2 times, 3 times, and then work your way out. If you are away from your computer, let's say you are going for work or travel, but you see there is a very good order block over here that you may not be in front of the computer, you just make the auto order block to true over here, and how many re-entry you are willing to do in case the price hit a stop loss. If you are not willing to hit the stop loss, well, basically you do not need the box, you just put the pending sell over here one time. This auto order is only good if you are willing to make the re-entry process over here. If you think zero, you do not need the auto order blocks at all, you just make it false. But if you are willing to have another re-entry, for example, 2 or 3 like me, like this, you can make this true and you draw your order block. So it will open the moment the price hit your order block, it will open order. Now, how about if I want a 50% over here? It's easy. You just adjust your order block on 50% like that. This is the same. The price come back here at 50%. It will make a sell order. You have to understand the concept first. You have to draw your own order block, right? And second, you have to make this non-active. You have to make sure there is no dots at the corner. You have to make it disappear, unselected. Now, number 3, you have to understand if the price coming from the bottom, it will sell. If you put the block here, the price coming from the top, it will buy. You cannot, for example, let's say this is your order block. So you cannot do this. The price coming from the bottom and goes up, passing your order block. And then you put your order block here, hoping this is gonna sell. No, it's not gonna sell. It is gonna buy. Why? Because the price is coming from the top. If you see the price is already at the top, you do not want to use this. You only want to use this if the price still below. I hope you understand what I mean. Always remember that if the price already passing your order block, you do not want, this is the order block, I will just use auto order block, and then you make it non-active like this. The moment the price come back here, because it's coming from the top, instead of it's a sell, it's gonna buy. So you really gotta be careful. That's why I make it by default as false. If you feel uncomfortable or afraid that you make a mistake, you better just don't use it, because it's really need focus when you are using that tool. If the price is already above, you can just simply use pending sell instead of using the auto order block over here. For example, at 50%, like that, you do not need the box. You just do that and it's come back and it will sell instead of it's buy. So you will understand. I think the most important thing is all been explained here. Now, as far as the drawing tool, it's self-explanatory. Let's go to daily. Let's say you want to mark this on daily. I like to mark this with Gainsborough with the gray color over here. This is my order block. So let's just close this because we are not using it anymore. So this is our order block. This is my swing high. This is my swing low. And here is the breakout structure. I always draw like this, so it will always remind me what is what. Here is the breakout structure. The order block is the last bullish candle before the breakout happened. We are waiting the price to come back here. And when the price come back here, you will get an alert when it hit your box. Now let's go to H4. This is D1 order block. Now here is from H4. Now we go to H1. And we know that this is H4 order block. You just keep doing that for easy click, for easy analysis. It will be good for you to just click away. This is D1 order block. This is H4 order block. Maybe you want to add later on, this is H1 order block. over here. So when you go to lower time frame, you know what is what and know where you are in the market. Let me show you something. Here there is BOS display. If you want to change it, some people are more familiar with break market structure or maybe point display. You want to change it, become PRZ, which is potential reversal zone. You can change it, but only these two, right? The rest you cannot. We just make it only for these two. That is become BMS and this is become PRZ, potential reversal zone, and this is break market of structure. So you can change these two if you want. So I guess that is all the explanation. Oh, I forgot how you get it. How to get it? You have to go to mqelf.com. You need to have an account. You just go to market over here and click on utilities, and oh, we are number one now. Yay! So here is the Star Seed FX. So you just click on it, and this is one-time fee for a lifetime access, and you get a lifetime update. Only one-time fee, and you got 5 activation, meaning this is for 5 computer. You may want to use on laptop, VPS, desktop, or maybe one day you change your computer. So you have 5 license. You can try demo first and see what is what. Currently, we are at version 3.2. We will keep updated. So whenever you have suggestion, you can always tell us in the group if it is doable, if it is good. So we will do it. And by the time when I make this video, the MT5 version is not available yet because the programmer has a delay. You see, during this pandemic time, it's not really easy sometimes to work. Anyway, as soon as the MT5 version available, I will make it sure that I will leave around here. And one more thing, for those who are using iMac, you really have to be careful. We have a member who is using iMac. It is very difficult sometimes from one broker to the other broker if you are using iMac. If you are using desktop or Windows, it will be so smooth using all this. So you can check it, what is what here, what this tool can do for you. I hope now you know how to use the tool, and we all can have the same tool and posting in the group with the same strategy, the same tool. It will be fun. If you have any problem after purchasing these tools, you can always contact me in the group. I will forward you to several people who are the computer engineer who can help you, like Aznan. He's my nephew and is also admin in the group. He can help you to fix the problem you may have, because sometimes some people said, oh, I click pending sell, but it doesn't make any order like this. And turns out what he forgot is that the auto trading. There are sometimes a simple things that may confuse people, which is normal. So you just can contact us if there is any difficulties on the tool, and we'll help you to get it fixed. So that is all for now. Thank you so much for your support, and thank you so much for purchasing the tool. If you still have any question, you can ask in the group. Thank you. Bye-bye.